you know, YouTube looks like it's set up. So YouTube, there's no one watching it yet, but maybe someone will watch it at some point. Tash.
If they want to.
Yeah. Okay, hang on. Let's start class.
Yeah. Hi. Hello.
Okay.
This is Jethro.
This is Monique.
Hi.
Hi, team. We are doing swing outs. Hey! This is our Lindy 2 class. So hello to everyone on Zoom. And hello to everyone on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently Tash said she was going to watch it in the morning, so she should be watching that by now.
Oh yeah.
So thanks for dropping in to say hi. And yes, hopefully we'll see you on Thursday as well. Mm-hmm. So just getting some dancers from the East Coast joining us, which is great.
It's like a million o'clock there.
Yeah, but Nathan and Cassie do it from Tasmania.
Yeah.
So it's not that unreasonable. It is pretty late though. But it's iso hop. Like, anyway. Anyway, this is our Lindy Hop class. We're doing swing outs.
Yeah, we're going to do a warm-up before we do swing-outs. We're doing swing-outs, but we're not yet.
Not quite yet. Can everyone just wave your hands to make sure that I can hear you? Wave your hands if you can hear us. Sweet as.
Wave your hands if you can see us.
Yep, cool.
We're going to assume you waved.
Sorry, I had the wrong window open as I asked that. Okay, here's the warm-up team. Let's do this one. Beautiful. Oh, wait, hang on.
Yeah.
Music. Pause. Someone had a comment.
Ooh, what did they say?
I checked the YouTube stream earlier and it was weird. Hand puppets. Yes.
No.
Yes, Angel, you may have walked in on a weird part of that class. We had played a song and all the students were doing good things and we were getting bored.
We were dancing,
so.
And we weren't getting bored, we were watching them dance, but also I just discovered that you could make hand puppets and things.
So we had a bit of fun with that. Okay, yes, okay. Swing outs.
Yeah.
I think we'll make them do it solo first.
Ooh, okay, yeah.
So we're going to just break down a swing out and make you do every little part perfectly. And then we'll try it together. So leaders, we're going to go 45 degrees with your left foot. And then your right foot steps beside your left. It's going to be a 1, 2. And your body does start rotating during that bit. So we start facing forwards, we finish facing 45. That's your 1, 2.
Cool. Follows are 1, 2. We're also going to start facing forwards. I will say this is going to be a swing out without swivels. So we're not adding swivels at the moment. So we're going to start 1, 2. It's going to be 1 on the spot, and 2 will be forward. On the spot, forward, and we'll start to turn to our right as we do that.
All right. Leaders, your triple step, your 3 and 4, is going to be on that 45 degree angle. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it's my left leg triple stepping on that 45. As I do that triple step, 1, 2, 3, and 4, I have to actually be turning so I finish facing the back. So you're going to finish with your back to me. It's going to be a back together triple step. I travel in a straight line, but I'm turning my body. 45 degrees, back together, then triple step. Back on that 45 degree line as I turn my body.
All right, cool. Well, so our 3 and 4, so we've just done our 1, 2. Our 3 and 4, we're going to continue to travel this way, away from the camera. And we're going to rotate our body. In order to do that, we have to do this weird crossing our feet thing. So long as we keep a decent distance between these and we keep our weight forward, it's not too bad. So we want to be turned almost all the way around, most of like 90%, to be facing the other way.
Here we go.
Yeah.
So let's just try to get, if you want to...
Oh, yes, I'll be over here, that would make sense.
Here we go.
Yeah.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And again. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And again. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4. One more. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Sweet. So we've got our triple step on a 45 degree angle, leads off on an angle, triple step back on this angle. We're now going to keep turning and step sideways. So that count 5 is also stepping towards me. So if Alma was my camera, I'm going to go back together, triple step, step.
Hi.
All in the same direction.
All right, yes, doing your thing, not being weird, sorry. All right, cool, so if Jethro is my camera, thank you. I'm going to do the first 4 counts.
Yes,
4 counts.
And five.
Right. 1, 2, I start turning on 2, 3, and 4. 5. So doing this 4, my body is still kind of going backwards. 4, 5. It's not a very big step, but I'm going back that way.
Cool. So follows have changed directions on 5, leaders have not.
What?
So if we do it sideways beside each other, both dancing this way. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. So you can see that the follows have changed directions, but the leaders haven't. 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. All right, let's give that a go. Let's try all the way to five. Five,
six, five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and four, five.
And again. A five,
six, seven, eight, one, two, three, and four, five.
And again. A five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, and four, five.
Oh,
cool. Leaders, I would like you to think about your shoulders.
Mm-hmm.
So when we're doing a six count base, an eight count basic, one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. My one, two, three, and four is kind of my left side of my body. Left and lefty left, five, six, seven, eight. Five, six, seven, eight. My right hand side of the body. So if we think about that while we're doing a swing out, I want you to lead with your left side of your body on the one, two, three, and four. And on the five, we're actually swapped and it's gonna be the right hand side of the body. So if we are doing it sideways, my camera's in front of me. Left shoulder first. One, two, lefty left. On this five, it is swapped. It's now my right side of my body. Boom. I'm leading this way with the right hand side. So I'm going lefty, 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 right on that count five.
All right, so we have, before I do any more things,
we've
got a question from Anna Sophia about whether this is an iso hop or a normal swing out.
Yes.
This is a normal swing out. You said because you normally step, you normally stay on the spot for your one and two, yes? So that will, it will very much depend on basically how the swing out is going, what your partner is doing, and what you're being led to do. A lot of the time we do stay on the spot for one and two. The reason that I'm saying on the spot forward is more to do with how Jethro would be leading me in this swing out.
So because we're asking the leaders to go backwards and then together.
Yeah.
So we're going backwards and then together. You can see my body is going backwards on that two. Going one, two. So because I'm going to be going away from Almo on that two, if we were connected,
that will cause me to want to come forward on the two.
Six, seven, eight, one, two.
But if that's not how your swing out is being led, obviously, and a lot of the time it won't be.
If it was just a rock step, so if I was going one, two, six. Seven, eight, one, two. Oh, a back fat. So that would be on the spot.
I'd be on the spot. Okay,
if I do a rock step, my body kind of stays here. That's more on the spotty.
This is true, yes.
But
yes,
if I
yes.
did six, seven, eight, one, two. And I would start to get in that rotation to three and four. So if leaders are rock stepping, it's going to be on the spot. If they're going back together, it's going to be on the spot forwards. If they get lots of tension at the eight, I can actually get Almo to step forwards on the one as well. But yeah. That's another class.
Yeah, it's not a hard and fast rule for followers to step in a particular place because, yeah. But good question, thank you.
Yes.
Yes, 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 yes. Yes? Yeah.
All right. We've got to count five.
Five.
Count six is another step. Seven, eight is a triple step. And that can kind of be whatever you want it to be. The important thing is to count four and to count five to a certain extent. After that, you can kind of let the follow go and kind of just manage yourself and get yourself where you need to get to. So leaders, it is, so I'm going to do it this way, back together, triple step, keep turning, we're going to step sideways on count five, and then we're going to get back to where we started with our step, triple step. So back together, triple step, side rock, triple step. So leaders, we need to be able to do all of this by ourselves, as well as with a partner.
All right, and so followers, our footwork will be on the spot forward, triple step, and then we'll start traveling the other direction on the five, five, six, seven, eight, from a different angle. That'll be one, two, three, and four, 5, keep rotating on the 6, 7, 8.
Cool. Alright, let's all try and do a few swing outs by ourselves.
Solo swing out, down.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5, 6, the leaders, it's back together, triple step, side rock, triple step, back together, triple step, side rock, and follows is
together, forward, triple step, open, open, triple step, together, forward, triple step, turn back,
and relax there. Woo, I'm dizzy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Are there any questions? Can we swing out by ourselves? It's looking good.
Yeah.
No one's rushing to the laptop to type anything. Brilliant.
Cool.
When you add a human in there, or Anna Sophia, are you going to do it? Yes.
Yeah.
More questions are good. All right. When we add a human in, we still want to keep those, that movement the same, where our bodies go in space the same, but it may move less or move more depending on where your partner is.
Yeah.
So you may have to adjust your footwork. Still try to be true to that direction that we were going, but you will definitely have to adjust and probably take smaller steps. So we do the exact same thing with the human.
Okay.
6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you can both do a swing out by yourselves, then you should be able to do this without any connection at all.
Technically.
But do it connected. So if you've got a partner you can dance with, connect up and do it, because it is easier doing it connected. It'll be more familiar for you guys.
If you have a
Andrew's got a partner dancing with. Is it a little minion or is it a... Hey! I'm not even sure what kind of animal that is.
That is a plush toy of some description and it makes me very happy. Andrew's about to tell us what kind of plush toy it is. Yes.
Fat pony. It's a pony?
It's a fat pony.
Jeez, it's got no neck at all.
Pony.
Okay, fair enough.
Oh, it's a chunker.
A giant mane. Anyway, do some swing outs. By yourself or with a partner, completely up to you. Try and keep it as relaxed and easy as possible using all of those things we just explained. All right, we'll put a song on, have a quick play, and we'll figure out where to go to next.
Frankie and Johnny were sweethearts. At least that's the way the story goes. Frankie bought everything for Johnny, from his sports car to his Ivy League clothes. Oh, he was a man, all right. Oh, but he was doing a wrong. Just to show you what can happen, a friend came running to Frankie, said, you know, I wouldn't tell you no lie. I saw your man riding in his Jaguar with a chick named Nellie Bly. Oh, and if he was your man, honey, let me tell you, he was doing you wrong. Let me tell the story. Frankie ran around the corner and peeped in a swinging place. And there she saw Johnny with the woman. He had his arm around her waist. Oh, he was a man, all right. But Frankie could see that he was doing her wrong. And oh, let me tell you, Frankie reached down in a pocketbook and up with a long 44. She shot. She shot him because she was doing her wrong. But the last thing he told her was, Frankie, you know
yeah,
I love you. Why? Honey, why did you do that, Frankie? I was telling her about you, Frankie. You know I love you, Frankie. You know that I love you, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, good job, team. So that's a quick recap of our swing outs. I have got a tip for leads. I've got two tips for leads. No, I don't. I've got one tip for leads. All right.
You sure?
Yes, I'm going to go with just the one. So I'm trying to decide whether or not the other one is worthwhile mentioning. It's probably not, because I feel like it's just an artifact of something that doesn't usually happen. Anyway,
we'll see.
The second one doesn't actually, won't apply in real life. This first one, though, is actually quite useful. I didn't find this out for quite a while. It wasn't until I was going to exchanges.
Oh.
Leaders, your right hand does have to catch the follow's back for a swing out.
Yeah.
It's really tempting to go one, two, and actually start reaching forwards and try to connect with the follow's back sooner than you need to. There is no need to catch the follow's back early.
We're coming to you.
Let the follow's back go into your arm. So rather than going a one, two, three, and reaching forwards to catch, which means that your right side of your body is going to be trying to come forwards when it's your left side that needs to be going forwards. So if I'm trying to catch with my right, but lean with my left, one, two, three,
no.
It can either make me rotate the wrong direction or just get me all tangled up. So if I'm leading with my left side, my right hand just hangs back and Elmo's going to end up just here because that's where she's going.
Magic.
Six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and four. There's no need for this hand to reach to your follow. Let the follow come into this hand and it will make your rotation a lot easier and make everything a bit more chilled. You do have to catch them at some point.
Well.
You need to connect and redirect them on that three and four.
If you want it to be a swing out, yes.
But you don't need to catch them before the end, I think. Hang on, when do I actually catch you? Six. A five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and four. Yeah, probably just before the end. So you don't need to catch on the three or before the three, but just after you do kind of start needing to get the follow ready to change direction on that four, five.
Follows. This is a lot easier if the leads can trust that if they leave their arm behind, we'll run into it with our backs.
Yes, please.
Yes. I like to think of it like, I assume that it's going to be one of those, it's going to be a pass-by, where we stay face-to-face, so like this one. If I assume that feeling and that shape, I turn, I keep facing Jethro, and when he catches me, it's like, oh, it's a swing out. Even if I was 90% sure it was going to be one already, but it means that I'm definitely putting my back into Jethro's arm, which is good for everyone.
You can do it. You can do it. Put your back. Okay. Just do a couple of swing outs without a song, just with those things in mind. Practice those two technique-y things, and then we'll move on to the next set of drills and games. Go! Just two or three swing outs, just to, you know, leaders, have they got leaving their arm behind? Don't reach for the follows. And follows, it's just going to be a pass-by. Yeah, nice.
Nice. Yeah, that's good.
Sweet. I'm in with that. All right. Looking good, team. And come back. All right. Hold on to that. It's looking good. Keep it. And then we'll, you know, use it later. Magnets.
How do they work?
I don't know. It's magic.
Use magnets to paint car. Windshield green. Infinite green lights. Don't do this.
So we're going to have the follows. Actually, we can come closer for this one.
We can.
Follows are going to have their hands facing down as if they're just connected and open. And leaders, you are going to put your hands underneath theirs, make contact, and they can either push their hands up, or if you pull your hands down, the follows will maintain contact because they want to maintain contact, not because I've grabbed hold of their hands and I'm pulling them down. I am not doing anything to pull Ammo's hands down. My hands are completely open and flat. I can push up or I can trust Elmo's magnetic abilities to be magneted to my hands.
Mm-hmm. I'm like constantly thinking about trying to maintain, so Jethro creates the connection. I don't make a connection. But once that connection is created, we have equal responsibilities in maintaining it. So I am also looking to maintain that connection.
All right. From here, leaders can disconnect. Sure.
Hi.
And they can put their hands on top of the follow's hands.
Sure. Oh, what? Yeah. Okay, cool.
And
now
again,
I am upwards.
I can guide Almo's hands down by pushing hands down. Or I can magnetically raise them up.
My hands are now helium balloons.
Or down. And same thing on the sides.
Mm-hmm.
Almo's hands are still facing down,
mm-hmm.
but my hands on the sides, I can either push the hands together, or I can magnetically pull them apart, or I can have one hand on top and pull this hand up and push it down. I can push this hand up, this one's pushing down.
This is very confusing.
I can pull this one out to the side, shoop. So I can kind of move my hands around in different ways.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be hard because we're doing it completely visually,
mm-hmm.
but theoretically...
It's easier when you can touch.
Follows, close your eyes, and leaders, move your hand from different connection points and have a go at magnet connection as well as pushing. Don't just push all the time.
Follows, we keep our hands facing down at
yes.
all times. Otherwise, we'll start trying to chase our partner's hands around. So if you keep your hands facing down and whichever surface your partner connects to, keep that connection.
Now, we've got two leads without a partner. So do you want to try to do this magnet game via...
Oh
Zoom?
My god, yes.
Alright, give it a go.
Alright, can we maximize a human?
Yes.
Okay.
Who
so we're
going to
start with Andrew because he's higher up, I think, on the thing.
Alright, Andrew,
yeah.
you
the Zoom
are going
to
try
first.
It with
and
Monique.
Cool. Alright, okay, yep.
Tai Chi.
I know. It does look like Tai Chi, yes.
Breathe in. And out. Play the piano. Cool.
That was awesome. Thank
Beautiful
you, Andrew.
Alright, shall we pin Noel as well?
Yes, we're going to pin Noel to the thingy.
Alright, Noel, you're up. No pressure.
Okay. Let's do this. And that. Oh wait, they're on top, sorry. You're just out of frame.
Cool. Looking good. All right. Nice team. Let's get back to gallery view.
That was awesome.
All right. Okay. So I hope everyone's got their magnetic hands all warmed up. We're now going to use these magnety ideas to actually walk the follow around as well. So.
Oh, yeah. We can go for walks now.
So I've got Almo's hands magneted to mine. Honestly, I'm going to start underneath. I can move the hands up and down. Or I can move forward or backwards. And eventually it's going to get to a point where if Almo's hands just extend first, to maintain the magnetic connection, Almo has to take steps. So as the arms go first, so it's all arms to begin with, the feet don't take any steps at all, if possible. But as soon as the hands kind of go outside of that possible range, then the follows will have to take a few steps to keep that magnet going. Alright, so again, leads, there's no actual pulling or pushing in this one. It's just trust. Just the follows are going to magnet to your hands and you're going to have to move forwards or backwards. And follows will let the arms go first, but as soon as you get to like the end of your frame, you'll have to take a few steps.
It is more important, follows, to keep our shoulders in than to keep that connection. So if our partner steps back and we have a little bit of a gap between when they step and when we catch up with them, that's okay. It's better to do that than for us to let our shoulders roll forward, which is what I do every time I do this exercise, and I have to force myself not to, because I'm like, the connection is the only thing that matters. That is all.
Cool. All right, so let's do the same thing again. So we'll pin Andrew and we'll do it via the screen.
Do you want to like this way so we can see the forwards and backsies?
Yeah, if we do it sideways, that'd be good.
Yeah.
Okay, so Andrew is pinned. For those that have got a partner, partner up and do it as a partnership.
I'm just going to walk into Jethro.
All right, looking good. I'm going to pin Noel. We'll give Noel a go as well. And you are pinned. Noel, you're up.
Cool. All right, yes. No.
Relax it there. Cool. Okay. Back in gallery view. Nicely done.
Like, there's always a chance that the leads are just going to become power drunk after all. And, like, and I can make a this.
All right. So what I'd like us to do is to do a fist connection. So we've
fist
got
bump.
A fist bump. And leaders that can go backwards or forwards or backwards. Oh, actually, we've got one more thing to do first. Sorry, no hands at all.
No hands.
Sorry, I forgot this drill. I'm going to use my force field that I have. I've got my little bubble.
Human physical bubble. It's like we're in a little detergent bubble, except it's a lot more hardy than a regular detergent bubble.
I'm going to walk forwards. It's going to bump into Elmo's bubble, which is going to push Elmo backwards. Or if I walk backwards, our bubbles have stuck together.
And
there's going to be a little bit of bounce.
Like surface tension, that's cool.
There's going to be a little bit of delay, but that's fine. Bubbles have that ability. So we're now just going to lead completely with our bubbles. All right, try that really quick. All right, we'll pin Andrew. We'll only do this for like 10 seconds because I want to move on to the next thing. Here we go, Andrew, go. Nice looking good. And I'm going to pin Noel. Nice. And go, Noel. Yeah, okay. So let's work on that then. Okay, so nice. We will call it there.
Thanks,
the next
Noel.
Thing we want to do is like Noel was trying to do, is trying to figure out how to swap sides.
How could you lead a turn, or how could you swap sides
without being confusing?
So
the way that we swap sides is by getting the follow moving forwards and then leaders getting out of the way. So if we're facing this direction here, I get you moving forwards.
Yep. So Jethro is now stepping backwards.
If I just turn around, there is no reason for Elmo to turn around, to come around me.
I just think he stopped dancing with me. I'm like, okay, all right, bye.
However, if I get out of the way and Elmo's still got that force momentum, there is room for her to come forwards.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to get Elmo walking towards me, jump out of the way, and that way Elmo can get past. So I can go forwards or backwards, and when I'm going backwards, I can let Elmo pass. So again, it's leading and following just with our force fieldy bubbly things, but you can now swap sides as well. All right.
Now, The reason I'm turning here, obviously Jethro hasn't, like, you know, tapped my arm with his force field or, like, made me turn, but because this is an entirely visual thing, I am keeping an eye on him, because they're sneaky.
Don't trust him.
I mean, no, I have to trust you. That's how the dance
okay.
works.
Okay, trust me, the...
But, like, I'm keeping an eye because I need to see what Jethro is doing next, and so I'm going to stay facing him. Also, I feel like there is a little bit of direction that is given when he steps back and then comes this way. I feel like he's...
inviting through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, let's give it a go. So try with your partners. I'm going to pin Andrew, so Andrew and Mon can have a quick play. Go for it. You're all set. I'm not sure. I think sideways is going to be easier. Yeah, because otherwise I'm just going to turn it back to the camera. Try it sideways.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Ooh, then I turn my back to the camera. I always turn my back to the camera, don't I? How do I not?
Yeah, that seemed like it worked.
Yeah, yeah.
That was a thing.
Uh-huh. We've got it.
Thank you, Andrew. Cool. Okay. This is going to be difficult over Zoom, but you guys are nailing it. All right, Noel.
That was so cool.
Noel, you are pinned. You're up.
Okay.
Nice. Okay, it's totally working.
Ideal.
All right. Leaders, once we get out of the way like that, so once we've got the followers coming forwards and we've got out of the way, we're going to actually sneakily do a swing out to them. So we're going to be like, look, no hands. Look, we're not doing anything. I'm just going to walk backwards. And I'm going to walk forwards. And I'm going to walk backwards and then I'm going to get out of your way. And then I'm going to catch you and swing you around and send you back out where you started. So it's kind of this, it's kind of a swing out, but
kind
it's kind of more
out.
Just like a catch and a whee!
Yeah, there's not really any footwork happening at the moment,
no.
It's just all weird force fields and ninja stuff.
So I'm going to go backwards, get out of the way, there's some momentum, catch that energy, whoop, and then whoop, swing you back out this way.
Woo.
So it's kind of like a proto swing out.
Proto swing out, it's like protozoan.
Exactly, it's like a pre swing out, it's kind of like the fundamentals of what a swing out is and how
it
all works.
Could be, potentially, or one
could
of
be.
The ways of describing. I don't know. Is there ever a right answer? Maybe.
No, yeah, not. Okay, let's give it a go. Let's try pin Andrew and Noel again and see what happens. All right.
I feel like this is going to be really
It's going to be difficult,
tough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right,
do,
Andrew,
I
you're
think
up.
We have to start facing each other, don't we? Do we?
Yeah, try it facing, because it's going to be a full swing out. We'll,
uh-huh.
we'll do it facing. Yep,
all right,
try
okay,
it facing.
Okay.
Yep, give it a go. So as you walk backwards, forwards.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, that's a thing. That's a thing.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, let's give Noel a quick go.
Yes.
All right, Noel, you're up. Okay, so I think it's just the timing. So watch me quickly, Noel.
Uh-huh.
When I jump to the side, I have to be going backwards. So I go backwards and to the side. If
you
I'm going forwards,
out of the driveway.
Yeah, if I'm going forwards, I'm going to be pushing elbow to walk backwards. So I try that again,
uh-huh.
And yeah, reverse backwards and around the corner. it's going to be easier. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Nice.
Nice.
Cool. Looking good.
Thank you, Noel. That's cool.
Okay, so we have got all of these fundamentally things going.
Little bits, little stuff, weird things.
So what I'd like to do is swing out with this magnetic connection. So fist pump, swing outs. And the reason we do this is so that followers move themselves through space and leaders lead with their body. It's really tempting today, hey, let's do a swing out. And it becomes all very much about the biceps.
Which, I mean, you'll have one really great bicep. Both of you will have one really good bicep.
But it's a small muscle, like relative to your entire body, so just use your body, it's way easier.
Mm-hmm. We are lazy.
So for this to work, leaders, your whole body has to go backwards, including this arm. If I magnetize to Elmo, and my arm extends, there is no reason for Elmo to come forward.
I'll stay right here.
She's magnetized to this thing, so this entire piece has to come backwards.
And follows, likewise, I'm magnetized to it, but not to the point where I'm going to sacrifice my shoulders, or like, I'm not going to put my shoulder out to stay connected to Jethro's hand. If we separate for a moment, that's okay. Because they're magnets, they don't have to be touching.
So have a go at those swing outs with just a magnetic fist connection. Leaders, you can do this one. Leaders that are by themselves, you can do this training by yourself. We don't need to kind of pin Elmo for this one. Just make sure your whole body is going backwards with that arm. And then try to do the rest of the swing out. And yes, leaders, still catch with your right arm.
Yes.
So we're doing a normal swing out with the right arm. We still catch their back.
It's normal except for that outside hand connection. So follows right, leaders left.
Yeah. All right, you're gonna put a song on. Let's have a dance. This one. So swap between normal connection and magnetic connection. Make sure these swing outs are as relaxed and easy as possible. Okay. I see a few people working on a few different things there and brainstorming and chatting about bits and pieces. Are there any questions that you guys have as you guys have been working on stuff? Any sticky bits that were going, oh, that didn't really work, or like, that was fun? Are there any thing at all? No? Oh yeah, Anna Sophia maybe typing something in? Got her glasses on, she's looking ready.
Jethro, can you hear us?
Oh, hang on, I should be able to hear you. I don't know why I can't.
Oh, is it the thing again?
Okay, I'm just saying.
No, I can't hear you. Why is that not working? Wait a minute.
Try now.
Okay, so yes, the reason why I asked a question about stepping forward was because I thought you guys were starting from closed.
Oh, right. I'm sorry. We did not clarify that.
Oh, okay, that's unusual. But when you start from open, it makes a lot more sense.
Yes. Sorry, that is a good point from our point. We should
normally
explain that.
That is a very good point. Normally, if we start enclosed,
back, yeah.
Yeah, it'd be like a on the spot, or we might go slightly back for the first thing. Like,
Yeah. No, so that's exactly it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise, you clean up your lead.
Yep.
Yeah, that's, I mean, we try to avoid that, right? We're like, fellas, don't race forward if you're doing a swing out from closed.
Okay. Yeah. Cool. Cheers, Anna Sophia. Any other questions or comments? Okay. In that case, let's give them one more thing.
One more thing. Okay, yes.
RJ.
Yes. RJ.
So this is a really fun pattern that doesn't get social dance very often as far as I'm aware. Do you follow it very often? Does it happen for
you? No, I don't get it. Like, it does. I've had it a few times, but normally, no. Normally, it's like a surprise sugar push will happen instead of the RJ.
Oh, yeah, okay. So an RJ is very similar to a swing out. The only difference is you don't go all the way around your partner.
No.
So if we do it here, and you go 1, 2, 3, and 4 is my swing out position.
Yeah.
3 and 4 is my RJ position. So I don't get onto Elmo's line on that count four leads.
Fellas, it's the same.
Out of the way, and then stay on my side of the line.
Ah, fellas, we do the same thing.
So 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I'm still catching Elmo's back with my right hand. I'm just not getting into her line. I am staying on this side of the body. So everyone just try that really quickly. Leaders, we're going sideways, or sorry, diagonally, shoop-de-doo, but triple stepping on our new line that is parallel to the follows. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And again, let's race it up this way. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And one more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right. So if I'm facing this way and I've got my ghost of a follow, I'm getting out of the way. The follow's got their line, they're coming through. I am catching their back, but because I am still outside of their line, I can just guide the follow to go back down that same line.
Okay, back where you came from, thank you.
We don't actually go around each other now. So may I do a RJ with you,
Monique? Yeah.
A 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's got this kind of like this S feeling to it. Draw the follow in, turn them around, send them back out.
Do you want to do it from like this side?
Yeah,
so
from the side.
So you can see some things.
5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So show them one more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, let's give that a go really quickly. Partner up, try your RJ, and we'll take it from there. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey, that's looking good. Do it again. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And a 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Beautiful. So the idea is that an RJ and a swing out are kind of the same in that the follows are staying on their line, traveling down the line, turning 180, and then traveling down the line and turning 180. Just the RJ second turn is the opposite direction. So a swing out goes 180 and 180, mm-hmm. same direction. But an RJ goes 180 and then reverse 180 to come back where you started.
Also, I was gonna say, yeah, it's like someone's like, hey, come here, we're gonna do a swing out. Just kidding, bye, go back there.
And it's got this really nice leader's kind of catch and then guide back down that same side with this right hand. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, catch. Boom. But then sends back down that same side.
It almost looks like you're driving through with that right elbow.
Yeah, yeah, it's definitely, yeah. I feel like I'm leading with that elbow, yes. Now, RJ is the name for it. And the is just ask, what does it stand for? And it does, as far as I'm aware, mean reverse jerk.
Reverse
oh, wait,
jerk.
It was Russell that was asking it, sorry. Yeah, it means reverse jerk. I don't know why this move is called reverse jerk. It's not jerky, it's really smooth and flowy.
Like, it's most likely that it, I would assume it's because it was like the nickname of someone, or it was what someone who had started doing it and other people were like, what is that thing you're doing? I'm like, it's a reverse jerk. I don't know.
Yeah.
I assume it was someone's nickname for some reason. Like their nickname was Jerk. I don't know. That sounds weird.
Could have been. But yeah, I'm not sure where it came from, but that's pretty standard. Every time I've done this class, that's what it's been called. What about
a hold and release? No?
Yep, let's watch.
Okay, yes,
we're going to demonstrate. Yeah, okay. So you can kind of just get that stretch point and just stop and just not lead the through.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You can. Yes.
Yeah. The other thing that I quite like doing is an inside turn out of it. So because you've got stepping forwards on that 5, 1, 2, 3, and 4, Alma's stepping forwards on 5, which is actually quite twisted. Her left foot is forward, but I'm holding onto her right hand.
You can't really see that from here, because I feel like...
So after Alma step forward on that 5, I can then swoop my hand on the inside, woo, to get an inside turn out of it.
And because I'm so twisted, I felt a lot of... Talk?
Yeah. 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. That's a really nice way of using that twisty, talky energy as well.
Mm-hmm.
Inside turn, starting on the 6.
Yeah, it feels really cool as a follow, because you've got a lot of power going into that turn.
other way, Andy. It's an inside turn. Other way. So rather than going under the arm like an archway, you've got to swoop it between you. So Ruth will be turning to her.
I'll be turning back over my left shoulder.
Left shoulder. Yep, that's the spin. That's the direction.
Yes.
That happens on the 6, 7, and 8. That's the one. Beautiful.
Nice.
Cool. So yeah, that's our swing outs. And that's our kind of magnetic swing outs using our body force, language and the force. Rather than having to yank and pull each other
we're
around
like
the swing outs.
One day late for that class.
I know. Happy May the 4th for yesterday.
It's now Revenge of the 5th.
And yes, of course, Anna Sophia, yes, our outside turns work too.
Yes.
So the RJ with an outside turn, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you've got these RJs, they either go straight or with the turns, either inside or outside. But yeah, lots of things to play with your swing outs. Make sure it's as linear as possible. Stay on a straight line where you can. Stay relaxed. There shouldn't be any effort or pulling and pushing when you're doing it relaxed. When you want to, you should be able to step it up and put in that energy for counterbalance and crank and stuff. But default, like my philosophy at least is do it as easy as you can first and then you can add stuff on top. If your default is quite intense and strong and pulley and pushy, then it's hard to make it less.
It's like if you wrote every email at work that you ever wrote in entirely caps lock. You want people to know when you're yelling at them.
It's exactly
what
it is. If
you put an exclamation mark at the end of every sentence, they'll just think you're perpetually excited.
But maybe we are.
Maybe, it's entirely possible. But like, make sure that your meaning is conveyed. If like 90% of your correspondence is like vanilla, or like, you know, any variation from that will be very noticeable.
Yeah. All right. And that's it. We are going to do more work on swing outs. We've got some complicated stuff like swinging outs on 2, swing outs on 7. We've got forwards and backwards and RJs behind the backsy stuff.
Behind the backsy stuff. Don't ever turn your back on a follow, except sometimes you gotta.
Yeah, there's a few fun things to do from swing outs. So we'll make them more complicated in these few weeks. We just wanted to make sure that we had a nice default swing out first. So hence why we did lots of work on that.
This is not the only default swing out that there is in the world.
No.
And if you've learned other ones before, or you've learned other ones from us,
they work too.
They also work.
All right. Thanks very much, Dean. Thank you, Armo.
Thank you, Jet. Thank you all for coming.
Yeah, thank you for being here. We'll play some more music. Keep on dancing. Feel free to ask questions.
Thank you for coming to your own living room. But also, thank you for like using your bandwidth on us.
That's true. Yeah. Thanks for using
like,
internet.
You didn't have to.
Oh,
and you did, and that was really cool.
There's a few songs lined up. I wonder what could be his name. And we're all good. Cool.
He looks good to me.
And all I can see is his
fine brand.
I'm sorry. I
forgot what's
the name.
Hello. Andrew's nodding like what I'm saying makes sense.
That's the one. It was pronounced like it was spelled with the wrong letter.
It was spelled with a T, but it said with a D.
Yes,
yeah,
that one.
Yeah.
It was ages ago.
Yes, you have got it.
Don't be a stranger. Why don't you come over here?
Yeah, okay. So that's
if you're doing like the Tai Chi, or if you're doing the thing that people used to do in rain, so they're like in your face.
It was sped up Tai Chi, so a little
bit
gravy, yes. That be why. He's got such a fine brown frame. I wonder what could be his name. He looks good to me. Mr. When did you hit this
Nicole, good to see you too. Cheers, Andy.